the Courthouse Case of the Week, brought to you by the Courthouse Tavern, located at 310 Forbes Avenue in downtown Pittsburgh. It's crime to go anywhere else. Matt Desmond, Melissa Tukowski here with me now. And guys, who gets the game ball from the Steelers' victory first? You were here last week. Let's go to Melissa first.
All right. Well, no question in my mind. Rashard Mendenhall gets my game ball. No question. His power running got the momentum moving for the Steelers immediately. On the first drive, he got 30 yards, and it resulted in a touchdown. By the end of the first half, he had 100 yards. There's no question about it. He completely sealed the deal for the Steelers. This game was won in the first half, and it was all because of Rashard Mendenhall.
Matt?
You really have to look at the Steelers' defense. The steel curtain really showed up last night.
And you can't give the entire defense
a game ball. I'm going to, all right?
That's what
I said
first, too.
They're all going to share it,
can you
all right?
Get, no sharing. Just give one person.
All right.
The best
if I had to have one person to give it to, it'd probably be Lamar Woodley. He showed up with a pretty good sack last night. But, you know, I'm going to switch that real quick.
big play Willie Gay?
I'm actually going to say Ike Taylor because he's the one who made that forced fumble. And Ike Taylor really was playing a good game last night, and he had that forced fumble that created the fumble return for William Gay. So I'm going to have to go with Ike Taylor.
Why not Antonio Brown or Ben Roethlisberger in this situation? Down the stretch, they're making those big plays. In the first half, their offense rolled and their defense rolled. But late in the game, who was it? Who was it on that 3rd and 6?
Well, first of all, Matt Desmond, let me shut you down real quick.
Oh, okay.
non-existent defense in the second. Did we not almost lose, slip away?
Counter-argument. Rashard Mendenhall, very non-existent in the second half as well.
I agree with that. But the first half, he completely made up for it. Second half, 19 unanswered points. That's all I have to say about the defense. And if I were giving to the game ball to anyone on defense, it would be Ziggy Hood. Ziggy Hood had a great game. Antonio Brown will always, always, always be my favorite because of Central Michigan University. My prior alma mater.
Stop. You're done.
But no, Roethlisberger did have a great game. As much as I hate rooting for him, great game. But I don't think his presence, neither of those players' presence, was enough for me to give the game ball.
Well, this brings me back to something else that I talked about with you guys before the show. Has Ben Roethlisberger's image changed in your minds now that he's taken his team to the Super Bowl? I want to get to you a second because it looks like for you he hasn't.
Well, as a woman, I find it very difficult to root for him. And I think that if you can root for him, maybe that, you know, you need to put your womanly priorities ahead. It's difficult to do that. But those issues aside, he absolutely has. But it's because he's taken his team on such a good playoff run and now to the Super Bowl. If he was not doing well, no, his image would not have changed. They would say that these issues have affected him throughout the season. If you're playing well, all is forgiven.
But for you personally, it hasn't changed.
For me personally, I mean,
I'm asking about
you
personally.
I have strong values as a woman.
Because I want to ask Matt personally, too.
No, for me, I mean, as a player, he's doing really well. I'm glad he is my quarterback. Would I allow him to have a full conversation with me? Probably not. Would I, you know, speak to him? No. But am I glad he is my quarterback taking this team to the Super Bowl? Absolutely.
Has he changed in your eyes, Matt?
Well,
in
my eyes as a man. I'm going to say he has. I mean, when you come back from that suspension, coming off all that pressure that you've been given, I think he's been playing very well, and he's been probably the best quarterback coming off of suspension. Michael Vick's been a great quarterback this year. But, you know, looking at Big Ben, he's led this team to the Super Bowl. No one would have thought that the Pittsburgh Steelers would be in the Super Bowl right now after all the preseason acquisitions of Ben Roethlisberger not coming in after the suspension.
Next week, we're going to have to do our picks. And, you know, if you look back at the history of things, you know, Kobe Bryant, forgiven, basically. You look at Vic. I mean, people forget that he did what he did. Not saying that, you know, women and dogs are, you know, on that same level. I'm just saying that when athletes do wrong and they win, most of the time,
all
those things.
Yeah.
You're right. All is forgiven.